Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. When LLMs first hit the scene, it was kind of obvious to everyone that they would completely change education. Every student would have a tutor 24/7, highly personalized to them. But it's not all upside, because the way you use these LLMs to learn matters a lot. The devil is in the details. So today I want to take a look at two papers, this one and this one, that look at how exactly students use LLMs in an educational setting and how it can sometimes help and sometimes harm learning outcomes. By the way, I found both these papers via Ethan Mollick's LinkedIn. I'll link to all of these down in the description below. The interesting thing is that both these papers, even though they're in different settings with different levels of students, they find very similar results. And the headline result is that students that use LLMs for explanations and to engage more deeply with the material and to understand the material have much, much better outcomes than students who simply use an LLM to get solutions to problems. Now, at an intuitive level, I think that won't come as a surprise, especially to people who are teachers or who have spent time in some kind of academic environment. But both these studies construct experiments to get some quantitative details on the magnitude of the effect. The first paper is set in a master's course in data science and looks at a set of students that are learning Python, starting with just learning the language itself, going all the way up to solving machine learning problems in Python. And the students have access to a web app to teach them Python with some instructional material and questions and so on. And they divided these students into two groups, one which has access to an LLM and one that doesn't. And what they found after doing some analysis on the intent of the messages sent to the LLM was that the vast majority of students, 64%, straight up ask the LLM to solve questions. And only about 18% ask for explanations or an example. So they try to engage with the material at a deeper level. And what they found was that asking for explanation has a positive effect on exam performance. So this measure of post-test minus pre-test is how much better they performed on the exam compared to the problem sets that were embedded in the learning material. And conversely, students in the second group that simply asked ChatGPT for the solutions had a worse learning outcome. And the authors are hypothesizing that the underlying mechanism here is simply over-reliance on the LLM. If you use the LLM as a crutch to get solutions right away rather than learning and understanding the material, then yes, your learning outcomes are going to be worse. The second paper repeats a similar experiment, but it is not in programming. It is at the high school math level. And it also has a much greater population size. The first one had a population size of about 100, whereas this one has 1,000 students. The interesting thing about this paper is that they designed two LLM helpers. One was what they call GPT-Base, which is just standard LLMs. And the other one was GPT-Tutor, which they prompted specifically with instructions to serve as a tutor. And here's the main result. On assisted exams, which means that it was an open book exam where students could access one of these two LLM tools, performance significantly improved. But it improved much more for the GPT tutor case than the GPT base case. So 127% better performance with GPT tutor versus 48% better performance for GPT base. However, on a closed book, closed laptop exam, on an unassisted exam, the students that simply used the base GPT had a much worse outcome, 17% worse outcome. Whereas the students that used GPT Tutor did not have such a negative outcome. It was basically neutral. They didn't have a positive outcome either. And the underlying mechanism is the same. The students that use the LLM as a crutch performed much worse. The really interesting thing is that the authors shared the prompting techniques that they used for GPT Tutor. And this was prompted such that it would help the student without giving them the answer right away. That's number one. And number two is that they worked with teachers to have examples of solutions of the problem along with common mistakes that students make when solving those problems. And I think these two things were the key to not having negative learning outcomes. So this was something that actually tried to make the student work and understand the material. So here you can see in the prompt how it says, ask them to show the work they have done so far. Do not provide them with help until they have provided this. And over here it says, you should provide the student with as little information as possible to help them solve the problem. Never provide the student with the full solution. And this is the part where they got input from teachers. A few notes about the problem and its solution. And so here it describes the steps you should take to solve the problem. It describes some underlying basic conceptual knowledge that the student should have. And then a bunch of common mistakes and how to nudge the student to fix those mistakes. So this is the interesting thing that's in the second paper. And this GPT tutor helped mitigate the negative learning outcomes from students that would simply try to ask the LLM for the solution to a problem. So that was a quick look at a couple of papers that look at how LLMs are used in learning, that give a warning for the ways in which LLMs should be used, and offer the same suggestion, which is that students should not be using LLMs as a crutch to get solutions right away that leads to worse learning outcomes. Instead, they should be using LLMs to engage with the material, to understand the material, ask questions, get examples, and so on. And that leads to better or at least neutral learning outcomes. I hope you enjoyed that. If you like content like this, please consider subscribing, like the video, and I will see you next time. Thank you very much.